Well, it has been a hell of a week for musicians' birthdays, starting with Albert Hammond Jr. of the Strokes. I love the Strokes, I love the Strokes, I love the Strokes a whole lot. Albert is the one who wears three-piece suits, and he has impeccable downstroke technique that I've studied on many a late-night YouTube binge. Just this circular motion with his arm that I don't know that it's actually anatomically possible for that to yield this downstroke that he has, but it does. Here from Room on Fire, perhaps my favorite Strokes record, is a song that Albert co-wrote with Julian Casablancas called Automatic Stop.
So many fish live in the sea. I wanted you, you wanted me. That's just a phase, it's got to pass. I was a train moving too fast. Didn't understand what to see. Oh, then I got a different view. Yes, you're gone.
I hit it out with my love. Fantasies out here right in front of you on the radio. That's Chris Eldridge, by the way, playing the part of Albert Hammond Jr. Happy birthday, Albert. Sorry, was that dead air? I was putting away my electric guitar. Oh, man. Uh-oh. And I just dropped my pick. Herbie Hancock, y'all. Where to even begin, or where to even begin? The playing, the writing, the scope of his activity. The man is a hero of all seven people in this band, and probably for seven different reasons. Here's the title track from his debut solo recording, Maiden Voyage.
Just keeps getting vibier and vibier from that point on because it's Herbie Hancock.
Ooh, Loretta Lynn. Loretta Lynn, the coal miner's daughter, who became the first lady of country music on the strength of both her voice and pen. She wrote Coal Miner's Daughter. She wrote
Don't Come Home A-Drinkin' With Lovin' On Your Mind. And also this beauty, You Ain't Woman Enough to Take My Man. A one, a two, a one, a two, three,
You come to tell me something. You say I ought to know that he don't love me anymore, and I'll have to let him go. You say you're gonna take him, oh, but I don't think you can, 'cause you ain't woman enough to take my man. Women like you, they're a dime a dozen. You can buy 'em anywhere. For you to get to him, I have to move over, and I'm gonna stand right here. It'll be over my dead body, so get out while you can, 'cause you ain't woman enough to take my man. No, you ain't woman enough to take my man.
That's Gaby Moreno singing you some Loretta Lynn. We love you, Loretta. Well, well, well. This is the birthday week of not one, but two of my lifelong mentors, Sam Bush and Stuart Duncan. Sam Bush, Stuart Duncan. Sam is one of the greatest mandolin players of all time. Stuart, one of the greatest fiddlers of all time. Sam, Stuart, I love you both. Thank you for everything. Sam and Stuart were on a Bela Fleck record called Drive together, hugely influential on all of us, all the playing on that record. Alex Hargreaves back there on the fiddle, and I have learned their solos from the song Whitewater. Hargreaves on the fiddle. Happy birthday, Sam Bush and Stuart Duncan. So good. Which brings us to Bessie Smith. Bessie Smith, the Empress of the Blues, the most popular female blues singer of the 20s and 30s, and for very, very good reasons. So much power, so much control, so much heart. Here from 1929 is one of her biggest hits, Nobody Loves You When You're Down and Out.
Once I lived the life of a millionaire, spending my money I didn't care. I carried my friends out for a good time, buying bootleg liquor, champagne and wine. When I began to fall so low, I didn't have a friend and nobody. place to go. So if I ever get my hand on the collar again, I'm gonna hold on to it till the meat goes green. Nobody knows you when you're down and out. In my pocket, not one penny. In my friends, I haven't any. But if I ever get on my feet again, then I'll meet my long lost friend. It's mighty strange, without a doubt. Nobody knows you when you're down and out. I mean, when you're down and out.
That's Gaby Moreno singing some Bessie Smith for you. Happy birthday, all you incredible musicians.